Okay, so in the our chapter of international taxation, two topics have been covered with respect to the assignments. I had given you assignments over the last 2 weeks, and you had given me answers to those assignments. So, guys, first of all, let's discuss the answers which you have shared with me, and let's discuss the results, what you have written, what is the correct answer, etc., etc. And let's see who gets the Hall of Fame today. Hall of Fame is a prestigious title to get for the assignments which we do in our class. So, for any questions, you can just stop me, interrupt me in between. I'll be discussing the answers to the assignments first, the assignments which have been given to you. So, you have been given three assignments this week. The three assignments related to the permanent establishment concept, which is one of the most important concepts in our international taxation arena. And trust me, the quantum of litigation which is there on this particular subject is definitely very, very huge, very, very enormous as compared to the other concepts of international taxation. Permanent establishment, the quantum of litigation is huge in our country, and every company who's coming into the country is wondering whether they are forming a permanent establishment or not. And as you are aware, that once a company forms a permanent establishment, then it is necessary for them to pay taxes in India, to pay the requisite taxes, and they become that it is a taxable presence. Basically, the relevance of permanent establishment is that if you establish a permanent establishment in a particular country, then you are having a taxable presence, which means that all your activities will be taxable in the country, and all your activities will be monitored in that particular country, and they will be exigible to tax by the local laws of that particular country. So that is the relevance of having permanent establishment in India. So during the assignment, I had given you three questions. Let's discuss all the three questions one by one. But the first question is the most important question. The first assignment is the most important assignment, which only one student out of the whole group has been able to answer. What is that question? That question is, ABC, a company incorporated under laws of Mauritius, is engaged in designing and selling high-end jewelry in many parts of the world except India. ABC doesn't have any presence in India. Neither does it intend to establish any subsidiary in India. In December 2020, the company opened an outlet in Saket, Delhi, with an intention to display. Please observe and note the word display, to display its jewelry to Indian customers. Eventually, it became popular in the state and started receiving orders for the jewelry. Instead of opening a bank account in India, it requested the customers to pay in the Mauritian bank account. The invoices of foreign company were issued to the Indian customers on an email. The CFO of ABC is confident that ABC doesn't need to pay any taxes in India since company does not have any taxable presence. So guys, I have already noted down all your answers. I have already read through all your answers, but I want you to discuss with me what should the relevant answer be. So, Vaibhav Arora, if you can unmute yourself, let's see if you are audible to all of us. Vaibhav? Audible? No, Vaibhav, still there's a lot of disturbance. Do you have another mobile phone kept near to your laptop or this mobile phone? Keep your mobile phone, another mobile phone away. No, not audible. So, Yogesh, can you unmute yourself?
Sir.
Yes, Yogesh, what are your thoughts on this particular case study?
Sir, they told only display, sir. So,
You can open the camera also, Yogesh.
whether I am
Yes.
visible, sir?
Yes, you are visible.
Sir, in this case, they are only displaying the product, sir,
But
the
Yogesh,
jewelry.
eventually, are they only displaying the jewelry, or eventually have they also taken orders and going beyond their periphery of display only?
Sir, but through the website only they are selling
Placing the
the jewelry.
orders, right? But don't you think that using that storage, using that display, they are actually indirectly soliciting customer? That is the reason why the customers are approaching them for purchasing this jewelry.
Yes, sir, you told the same thing, sir, in the class also. In that
Yes.
case, website only will be taxable. Our government will not leave them. They will
Yes.
tax in this.
That's true. Nitin, please unmute yourself. Nitin.
Yes, sir.
Nitin, don't you think that after taking orders from the customers, the company has exceeded its close boundary of only being a storage or a just a display window?
Yes, sir. They are started taking orders from Indian customers, and
Yes.
I think they are has permanent establishment in India. So I think they are taxable in India.
Okay. So guys, the first part
Or
to the
income,
answer.
which is and when.
Yes. So guys, the first part of the answer is that yes, they have exceeded their activity. They should not have done the soliciting of orders and taking the orders. This is an activity which is impermissible. So permanent establishment definition specially contains a clause which says that if a premises is used as a sales outlet or for receiving or soliciting orders. So guys, they have started receiving orders on this outlet. So although they are telling you that it is a display window, it's just a display outlet, it's just a sales outlet, they are actually in a sense not using it as a display outlet only. They are actually using it as a outlet where the orders are received. Therefore, they are definitely covered under this generic definition of permanent establishment. The permanent establishment generic definition contains this. I have also written the exclusion on the screen. Please read the exclusion. The maintenance of stock or goods merchandise belonging to the enterprise solely for the purpose of storage or display. If their activities was limited to this exclusion, then I would have been convinced that yes, they didn't had a permanent establishment. But then since they have overruled their jurisdiction, since they have gone beyond and they have also received the orders, they shouldn't have received the orders. Since they have received the orders, this outlet runs a risk of becoming a permanent establishment of the foreign company in India. But guys, I've already always told you, always see the definition of permanent establishment in the relevant treaty. If in the relevant treaty the permanent establishment definition is given, you should always see it. Now let's check out the permanent establishment definition in the treaty. Let's see what the treaty says about permanent establishment. Okay, I'm on the income tax website, and on the income tax website I have chosen treaties, then I have chosen comprehensive agreements, and with which country I need Mauritius. Mauritius is the country with which I need the agreement and article number. Article number, guys, tell me what is the article number for permanent establishment. Anyone, what is the article number of permanent establishment?
Article number 5, sir.
Perfect, article number 5. So I've opened the article number 5 of Mauritius Treaty. This is permanent establishment. I am directly coming on to point number 2. Point number 2 defines the permanent establishment to contain these things: A, place of management; B, branch; C, an office; D, a factory; E, a workshop; F, a warehouse in relation to person storage facility for other; G, mine; H, firm, firm plantation or other place where agriculture work is done; or I, buildings, site, construction, etc., etc.; J, furnishing of consultancy services with some level of permanence. Now, I was harping upon this particular concept to you again and again on the WhatsApp group. Guys, can you see these words which are written in yellow? Premises used as sales outlet for receiving or soliciting orders. Can you see these lines in this definition
Sir,
in Mauritius Treaty? Okay, Yogesh, any thoughts on this treaty definition not containing
sir,
clause
in
on
the
sales?
Mauritius treaty,
Yes.
it is taxable.
It is
It is
what?
not taxable, sir.
Absolutely, absolutely. So
My
Yogesh,
think manager is correct.
Vaibhav, what are you saying?
I think manager is correct.
Manager
Not
is
taxable.
correct. Absolutely, manager is correct. Should the Indian sales outlet form a PE of the foreign company in India? Should it form a PE of Indian company, the foreign company? Answer is no. It should not form a PE of foreign company in India. So just read the conclusion as per the provisions of Section 90. In case of a conflict between Act and Treaty, more beneficial provisions may apply. Hence, as per the Indo-Mauritius Treaty, the sales outlet India will not qualify as a PE.
Sir, an example, we cannot मतलब वी डोंट हैव इंटरनेट इनकम टैक्स डेफिनेशन ना.
यस यस. सो प्रखर, दीज असाइनमेंट्स एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड ऑल ऑफ यू, दीज असाइनमेंट्स आर नॉट रिलेटेड टू योर एग्जामिनेशन, दीज आर जस्ट रिलेटेड टू योर जनरल नॉलेज, जनरल अवेयरनेस एंड योर प्रैक्टिकल एप्लीकेबिलिटी ऑफ लॉ. Purpose of these assignments are not to prepare you for the examination, but to prepare you for the interviews and the future dealings which you are going to do in income tax. For your examination perspective, I am taking tests. Those tests will be centered to examination, but these assignments are not subject to examination. Therefore, I am asking you to open the book, open Google whenever you want for doing these assignments. Got it?
Okay, sir.